I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making some great flavorful twice baked potatoes to go with our New York strip steak that we're going to grill out. To get started, we need to get our potatoes baking. I like to spray them with a little oil. A lot of times I just stick them in the oven right on the rack. It doesn't really matter. But one thing I will say is that you shouldn't put them in aluminum foil, because if you do that, you're going to have soft skins, and those will not hold up to making those cups that we need for stuffing the potatoes. So I'm just going to spray these a bit. And I kind of like them with a little bit of sea salt ground over the top of them. So if you happen to have that, you could do that, or just sprinkle a little regular salt. It's not necessary. This is just an optional step. This is on the outside. You can certainly add as much salt as you want later on. And those are ready to go in the oven. So that part is very easy. There's nothing much to baking the potato. So I'm going to just set this aside while I talk about what we're going to be adding in. Let me bring a mixing bowl over, and you'll notice that this is fairly large. I'm not adding all that much to the potatoes, but the potatoes themselves, when they get scooped out and that potato meat is in here, I'm going to want to have plenty of room to get it beat into a form that I can stuff the potato. Might use a mixer to do that. You can use a fork to mash it, but we'll need that extra space. Let me get rid of my canola oil here. Use any kind of oil you want, and also the salt. And we'll come back and I'll show you a few things that you can use, and you can be very creative on this. Whatever you like in a baked potato, just put it in. Starting with some sharp cheddar cheese that has been grated. I have 1/2 cup. And then the next thing I want to add is some sour cream. You can use fat-free, which I have here, or just going in here now. 1/2 cup sour cream. And as we move on down, I have butter. This is 1/2 stick of just regular butter, salted butter. And it's at room temperature. You do need it at room temperature, because you're going to blend these things, just kind of mash them up at this point. And then next, you can see I've really used up on my green onions. I need 1/4 cup. That goes in. 1/4 cup. And then the last thing I'm adding right now is a fresh parsley that I have just used my kitchen shears to snip like that. That's a really subtle flavor that is great in a dish like this. Now, I could add salt and pepper. I might decide to do that a little bit later in this recipe. My feeling is that if you're doing this for guests, people that you're not that familiar with, you really don't know how much salt that they are able to eat or that they want to eat. So maybe it's better just to hold off on the salt entirely. Obviously, potatoes generally need a little bit of salt. What I'm concentrating on now is getting all of the other flavors together. And the salt, I may put a little bit in when I come back to this mixture. When I have my potatoes ready, and there are some other things that I'll be adding at the very end. So we'll make our decision then. I'm going to go away now, let those potatoes bake, and I'll be back in 1 hour. It takes 1 hour at 400 degrees for those potatoes to get done. So I'll continue the recipe at that point. I have just taken my baked potatoes out of the oven, and you can see I am digging out the potato meat. It's steaming hot, so I took a potholder that is kind of old and beaten up. It was clean when I started, but all of that grease that was on the outside, you have to have a potholder that you don't care if you would get it messed up. So we scooped that one out. That's the last one, and we have our very hot potato meat right here. So what I'm going to do is quickly add in what I had in the refrigerator waiting for this. It really wouldn't have hurt for the 1 hour for me to set it out, but I usually try to take care of things pretty well. So I'm just going to dump that in and then very quickly mix this. I did decide to season it up a bit. I think that it would kind of be expected that they're going to have some degree of salt to them. So I think 1/2 teaspoon is going to be good. We'll sprinkle that over. It's 1/2 teaspoon of salt, and then just a dash of pepper here. Doesn't have to be too much. I'm not giving a measurement for it, and of course people can add their own pepper later if they want to. And then, as I said, we have to work with this pretty quickly, so I'm going to get in here and use a mixer. It's going to take a moment for me to do this. It's going to be noisy, so let me do this and I'll get back with you and show you what it looks like. I use my mixer to mix all of this up, and I'm through with the mixer. One additional ingredient is going to be some crisp bacon bits. If you watch my baked bacon and scrambled egg breakfast, then you know that I always keep in my freezer some bacon that's ready to go. So I just microwaved it for a minute or so and then put it in little chips. And I'm going to put it inside these potatoes. You could put it on top as a topping if you like, but I'm going to just mix this together at this point. Now I don't like to mix it with that original blend because it gets really soggy, and I would rather have it when it's kind of stiff like this, and then it maintains all of its crispness. And we'll fill each one of these four shells that have been made, and you just start, you pick one up. They're cool enough now that you can do it without a potholder, but you just spread it, and I'll do all of these and show you what it looks like. I've got all of these potatoes filled fairly equally, and I'm going to put some shredded cheddar on the top. I'm just going to do all of these by putting a little sprinkling on the top so they look nice and pretty. One last additive, and that is some paprika. I'm just about out, but I'm going to sprinkle a little paprika, get up high enough that it will disperse pretty well. You don't want it all clumping in one spot. But it's a nice flavor to add to any potato dish. So this is what our twice baked potatoes look like when they're done. I did bake them in a 400 degree oven for 20 minutes. And that was after I had them in the refrigerator. And then about an hour ahead of time, I got them out and let them come to room temperature. So just make your judgment about cooking them depending on how cold they are. If they've been frozen and thawed, or if they've come from the refrigerator, or if they're standing at room temperature. Keep looking in, and you can tell when they look like this, then they're done. They're going to be scrumptious. Place that on my serving plate. And then I think I mentioned to you that we made twice baked potatoes earlier in the day. And here they are. They're still a little hot. I got them out of the oven a few minutes ago, so they've been sitting for a while we did the steak. So let me just pick up one of these and put it over here on my serving plate, and we're ready to go. I normally would serve this with a nice green salad with some nice dressing, and perhaps French bread with olive oil for dipping. And then it's nice to have something like this for dessert. These are just strawberries that have been dipped into chocolate, and they've been refrigerated, so they would set up like that. And then, of course, always my favorite drink is iced tea. So I hope you enjoy this meal, in particular the steak.